chief guest of the day, Sri Sendal Kumar sir, assistant commissioner, Kendriya vidyalaya secretary. Dignitaries on the right hand side and learned friends. Myself, Prabhakaran, basically a student of history, by profession a teacher practitioner. I would like to share few of my ideas, particularly in the field of education. Pointing certain aspects of research activities on methodology, teaching methodology. Even though today's discussion is paper publication, my view which I would like to share with you, there are n number of UGC projects wonderfully undertaken, successfully carried out, wonderful papers also published in various subjects. Apart from that, there are many NGO agencies and other educational trusts and others monitoring and funding and supporting for many research projects. But in the field of methodology, teaching methodology, I feel that we need to little more attention. Most of the subjects in scholarly aspects, when you look at micro level analysis, wonderfully taken out. A lot of studies have been made in various subjects. But each subject, as a history teacher, while teaching history, the research methodology in teaching history, how best we can develop it. This is the area of discussion for me. Here, I would like to share one of the latest teaching methodology which is prominent in present day world, particularly on constructivism and how the reflection of learning can be taken into various levels. The learners, while learning, their reflection. Reflection at the time of learning. During the process of learning, definitely reflection, after reflection, and ongoing reflection on the third stage. All these things are the major area of concern. Let me look at, this is nothing but a different approach in teaching methodology. Next. See, this idea conceived end of 19th century, but the major areas of this kind of teaching we can look at most of the developed countries in the world. One thing is very clear, any new methodology, new education philosophy, as it is, we cannot import, and definitely there will be lot of problems in the scenario of each country, particularly Asian countries. Next. You can see in 1998, the slides very clear that effective grading in college level education, effective grading was a book published with regard to flipped classroom teaching. Next. It was further continued to 2000. There were research papers on this topic. Next. 2001, there was a concept of peer instruction. Thereafter, you can see the new methodology called flipped classroom teaching become very popular. The impact of ICT, information and communication technology, played a vital role in this aspect. Next. Next. Khan Academy is a popular organization. Salman Khan, his niece requested him to support for education. Definitely, Salman Khan was unable to do that. So what he did? He recorded all the lessons and handed over to her. Surprisingly, the methodology was well accepted, well received. Then Salman Khan started an academy. Now in the world, the most popular academy. It is the one of the landmark of flipped classroom. Next. You can see the, we are not going for an academic discussion here now. It's a new pedagogical approach. Here, the learner is in an active mode. The learner is in active mode. That is the most important thing. Textbooks, video lessons, internet resources, any sort of resources, the facilitator is providing to the learner, and the learner is now sitting and working. So the required instructions are already given to the learner and learner is working on it. Now homework is stopped, no more homework. Learner is now preparing the lesson, his own or her own, become a homework. Next. The lecture method now replaced. Next. There is a traditional pedagogy and the earlier one and the latest one. Now in the smallest group also they can sit in group also, because when they are working in a team they can work. So you may think that what's the need of this discussion here? The discussion is again and again I pinpoint on methodology of teaching and learning. In any subject, in any matter, it can be taken as a research topic and conduct research how my teaching and my methodology very effectively communicate the ideas and how ideas are able to pop up in the learner's mind. Next. I have already explained to this. Next. Here you can see, before the learning, the student is prepared. Previous situation, the teacher is preparing, now student is preparing. During the learning, the group is sitting and presenting it. And the last one is the third stage, is the right hand side. After learning, the reflection on learning, that is ongoing process, how the application of knowledge is connected with the real life situation and how the real life situation they are enjoying, then the learning becomes a joyful experience. Next. Here, short videos, lecture methods. That means the topic can be allotted to the learner and the learner is able to learn and come back and interact with the teacher, the facilitator. Naturally, the learner is in active mode. Next. As I told you, this experiment was made in America. Definitely, it's a product of America. Teaching methodology as it is may not be applicable in Indian situation. all the children may not be having the accessibility to the internet facilities. So in a classroom situation, out of 30, 40 or 50 students, the possibility of implementing certain policies and programs based on the flipped classroom may have a lot of problems. I agree with that. But there are opportunities in the school itself, college itself, where children can look into. Or this kind of innovations, how best we can modify and adopt it and develop it. This became a result. Next. The entire learning cycle goes like this. Concept exploration by the learner, identifying the required learning material, demonstration and application of the gained knowledge. My dear learner friends, I would like to conclude with this. One is the research methodology, how far we can improvise and new techniques can be made the learner more active, and the subject matter, how best we can transform the learners. Second area, institution wise, every college, every institution can take up certain projects which are innovative in nature and goal oriented, and it can be an action research or it can be an innovation and experimentation. That is my second area where I would like to highlight. That is, innovation and experimentation definitely will bring quality change in education. So, the present reality is doing micro studies in their own subject. It is wonderfully coming up. Research areas have improved a lot. Whereas I feel two areas, one is teaching methodology, second thing is institutional level, action research or innovation and experimentation may bring radical changes in the education scenario and may some of the Indian universities, Indian higher education institutions may come up in the world classical learning centers with this world. I take this opportunity to congratulate all the awardees and also my sincere thanks to the organizers, and thanks for all of you. Thank you.